Hello everybody, my name is Christine Kopf. I'm coming from the Deutsches Film Institut in Frankfurt, Germany. And first of all, many thanks to Petra and her team. Now she's gone, but for this invitation, I'm really happy to be here in Ljubljana for the first time. You can consider it as a marketing part of my presentation. I want to show you a short trailer first of the institution I'm coming from, but I also think it's interesting to see where we develop our projects of film education, because it's always connected to the kind of institution where you do your film education initiatives. So the first thing is the trailer of the German Film Institute. If I have it tap again, sorry. Next. German Cinematheque, and of course it's great, as you can see in the marketing trailer, but also for me personally it's really important to put in this wide range of activities and in our very diverse profile film education as a very important pillar. So I would like to talk very shortly on the Department of Film Education, and then I will come to the next point to tell you about the Mini Film Club. So The Department of Film Education was founded 5 years ago, and it consists of three pillars. The first one and the oldest one is the museum's education. It's active in doing workshops and guided tours since the 80s already, so there is a lot of experience. And at the moment, we have around 1,000 workshops a year, so you can imagine it's really a lot of logistics also. And we also reach a lot of people with film history, with the issue of film education and film history. And we have up to 30 freelancers who are in charge for this under the supervision of my colleague Daniela Dietrich. And then we have what we call our regular projects of the department. They come every year, that's why they're regular, if we are successful in applying for public money or donations, of course. So we have an intercultural film club with young people with and without refugee experience. We have our, it's regularly once a month since already 2 years, and I think it's very important that it's regular. And then we have our school cinema weeks all over Hessen, so we not only have initiatives or activities in Frankfurt, but also in the whole part of the country. We work together with 82 cinemas. And we reach a lot of young people. Then we have our Filmmobile workshops. So we go also outside our house into all these 82 cinemas, but also schools in the whole region, also in the rural region, which is, I think, really important, not to only have film education in the cities. And then we have, of course, training for teachers. Our department also work in close cooperation with other departments, like we have a film festival for young film fans, young film lovers, film fans, it's only in German, that doesn't matter, Lukas, and then our cinema department also organize CineFed and Brit films, which is interesting for foreign language teachers, and they really like it. And then, as you saw in the bombastic trailer, we have also family-friendly exhibitions, like Gontry's Film Factory, is also a film education experience, I guess, and for example, on Aardman. A third thing we do regularly is we try to come up with model projects, mostly financed by foundations, and this is a part where we can be innovative and experiment, but we try always to transfer the lessons learned in our daily museums education routine. I think this is very important to have the experience back in your everyday life. So for 2013 to 2017, Minifilm Club, the project I'm going to present to you, was one of our pilot and model projects. Now it's really a format you can book in everyday life. Then we had AB Cinema, a European film education project together with colleagues. We had a conference, international conference on film flight and interculturality. This came out of our intercultural film club, and the outcomes still influence also our everyday life at the moment. We're going to develop together with partners, also like Austrian Film Museum, a teacher training with this focus on interculturality. And we developed a multimedia guide for our permanent exhibition together with the young people. So they selected the objects and items, and they produced videos and interviews and so on the selected objects, because we were interested in their opinion on our house. And now the project I'm going to present to you, the Minifilm Club, we started in a new pilot project on a national level. So this is a context of the Minifilm Club development, and today I would like to introduce to you this one single format in the film education work of the Deutsches Film Institut that was developed most carefully and intensively, the Minifilm Club. I want to do this because I hope that it inspires you and that you can take something for your work with you, because it also has happened to me when I had the opportunity to exchange ideas with colleagues from other institutions, and I have always been able to learn something from it and to transfer it into my everyday life. And in this spirit, I am looking very much forward also to hear the following presentations today and tomorrow. First, we have a look at the Mini Film Club trailer, which gives you a little insight into what the format is all about. But I have to say it's not quite up to date anymore. We did it 2 years ago, and we're going to have a new one. But anyhow, I think it will give you an impression. Der Minifilmclub ist ein neues Format, das das Deutsche Filmmuseum zusammen mit zwei pädagogischen Einrichtungen erarbeitet hat. Was bedeutet, dass Kinder im Alter von 4 bis 6 bei uns ins Haus kommen und ein sehr reichhaltiges Programm geboten bekommen.
Insbesondere mit abstrakten Experimentalfilmen haben wir das Interesse der Kinder gewonnen, die am Anfang noch sehr, sehr skeptisch waren, aber inzwischen diese Filme regelrecht genießen, spontan reagieren und sehr, sehr aufmerksam sind. Und diese Aufmerksamkeit und die Offenheit auch für andere Filme, die Kinder vorher so nicht kannten, das ist ein ganz wichtiges Ziel unserer Arbeit.
Der Vorhang soll aufgemacht werden und das Licht aus.
Ein Mini-Film-Club-Erlebnis beginnt im Kino. Wir schauen gemeinsam einen Film, und zwar Kurzfilme, abstrakte Filme, Avantgarde-Filme, historische Filme. Im Anschluss arbeiten wir mit den Kindern kreativ. Also beispielsweise werden Bilder aus Steinen gelegt oder wir malen auf Film oder wir tanzen vor farbigen Schatten. Und im Anschluss gehen wir mit geschärften Sinnen nochmal ins Kino und schauen den Film erneut.
Immer wenn wir hier am Mainufer sind, auf dem Spielplatz, oder sagen, oh, unser Museum, das ist unser Museum. Also das heißt, sie haben einen ganz guten Zugang, einen positiven Blick auf ins Museum gehen. Also wenn ich frage im Morgenkreis, möchte jemand ins Museum, schreien alle, ja, ja, wir wollen, was nicht unbedingt normal ist, sage ich jetzt mal.
Wenn zum Beispiel der Vorführer eine Umarmung von einem Mini-Filmclub-Mitglied bekommt, wenn ich die Mini-Filmclub-Mitglieder mit ihren Eltern wieder im Museum auftauchen sehe, wenn die Kinder einfach ganz begeistert, während sie die Filme sehen, kommentieren, was sie auf der Leinwand sehen, wenn ich merke, dass ihnen Avantgarde-Filme so vertraut sind, als wäre es was ganz Normales, die zu sehen, dann bin ich ganz schön stolz. This gives you an impression of the format, and I want to start by explaining how the Mini Film Club is structured. I think that could be maybe interesting for you. If a kindergarten considers to book a Mini Film Club, everything starts with a training. We offer a 1 to 2 days training of the educational professionals from the kindergarten who is going to come and to book the format. And of course, we encourage the entire kindergarten team to participate, as acceptance of film as a medium of equal legitimacy alongside other educational offerings is a condition in order for it to gain entry to also to the facility, to the kindergarten. And we teach in this training as a team together with our partner kindergarten. This is also very important because I think peer-to-peer from educational professionals to educational professionals is a difference if we as a cultural institution are going to teach. So it's really important that we're doing this together. And in the training with the educators, we visit our permanent exhibition on pre-cinema. The cinema, of course, as the heart of the house, the premises, because we want the education professionals to feel very familiar in, with the institution. And of course, we gave a presentation of the minifilm concept and the pedagogical meta structure, why we're doing this. And we discuss also points of access to film literacy and our own concept as a film institution. Then we go to the cinema and we view the 6 films of the Mini Film Club edition and we present the active units. If you're interested which films are in the edition, I brought a paper. I know it's a paper-free conference, but I'm an analog type, so here's a paper. We introduce our educational materials. We have our own folder with worksheets for the educational professionals to prepare and also to have ideas how to work afterwards with the issue of cinema in the kindergarten, and everybody can take one home. At the end of the training, we have individual arrangements for the actual programs of each kindergarten, which is also, I think, important that you give you start to give the kindergarten the possibility not only to book a complete thing, but also to select what you like about the format and to choose the films. So you can choose 4 films from, at the moment, 6 in the edition, but we are at the moment also finding new films and going to enlarge the edition. So in future it will be more. And second step, also very important, we have a parents' evening in the film museum. Like usually every kindergarten, of course, has parent evenings, but this one, the next one for the kindergarten who is going to book the format, is happening in our house in the film museum. And we open up the building for the parents on a Monday. So this is a very exclusive event, so to say. And the parents can feel this. We really take this serious. The few sample of films from the edition, and I have to say it's always more difficult to show this experimental and avant-garde films to the parents than to the children, but we do it, of course, because we want them to know what their children are going to see. And also, of course, we present the concept and the program of the Mini Film Club. And additionally, on this evening is an exchange happening regarding the children's first film experience, subject of documentation, like declaration of agreement regarding photography rights and all this. And then the third step, finally, the children arrive at our house. And a Mini Film Club has 7 units in the Deutsches Film Museum. So 8 children always are one group, and they're aged 4 to 5 or 5 to 6. We try to have a similar age range because they develop so fast in this age. And the first session is exploring the building. The children explore all parts of the building, also the hidden parts, so to say. They're always very interested in the floors where you usually not can come as a visitor. And they get to know every space they will be active in for the next 8 sessions, like the permanent exhibition, the cinema, the workshop rooms, and the museum educational area. And they receive also digital cameras with which to photograph their favorite object or favorite place. So already here, we found often abstraction because they choose very often very small details. And the children's photos will be printed out and arranged in a painted poster of the film museum's layout, because this will also sharpen the children's orientation and the children's accustom themselves to the spaces in the museum. We really take our time for this because we know in this age it's really important to arrive on a space and to really be ready to have the next point. And at the end of the first unit, the children receive also their mini film club identity cards, which is also very important ritual, so to say. And all this is also inspired by Reggio Pedagogic. The second session is called Cinema Magic, Kino Magie, and it's very much inspired by Alejandro. We will hear him later. It's exploration of the cinema location itself. And together we have a look at the spatial situation. We explore the screen, the curtain, the auditorium. We collect together what is special about watching a film in cinema. We have a close look at the different material, like 35 millimeters, 16 millimeters. And of course, very important, the projection booth. We change between there and the auditorium, back and forth. And we have the first film viewing. It's a Lumière film, Arrival of a Train. And then we're discovering some of the general background information together, like we count seconds before the loop starts again. We are asking what's missing. Yes, it's a silent film, and so on. And at the end of the unit, there is a blank film game. This is also inspired by Alejandro. It's coming from him. The projectionist in the projection booth draws on a blank strip of film, and according to what the children by microphone in the auditorium call out. And at the end, this introduces the subject of abstraction and film without camera, already in preparation for the next meetings. So the third meeting is one of the chosen films and an active unit. Always after watching the film, they have an active unit, and then they watch the film again. And for example, if it's Begone Dark Hair by Norm Maclaren, the active unit is drawing on blank film with markers and transparent casein paint. So they get a feeling for the artistic method. And this is also followed by viewing their film in the cinema and viewing again also Norm Maclaren and Evelyn Lombard's film. Optional. Sometimes we also go to the children's facility and we bring the blank film painted with transparent casein paint. It has to dry first. And we screen it with a portable projector. And additional or alternative, we also making optical choice, such as a flip book, a thaumatrop, etc. So the second unit, now it somehow repeats, is the second film, an active unit, for example, A Game with Stones by Jan Schwankmeier. We have the film viewing, we have the active unit, for example, preparing flip books with stone characters or making an animation film at the animation table. This depends a bit on the age of the children. And the stones are collected and brought by the children themselves. And as you see, again, the next film and active unit, the next film and active unit. And then we have this closing celebration. No, sorry, we have the concluding request session at 7. The children in this session choose their film, their favorite film from the program, and we go into the permanent exhibition again or into the projection booth. So they kind of choose what we do at this last unit. And then also very importantly, we have the closing celebration. We invite the children to the museum with their families and friends and present also the filmic works that were made in the course of the Mini Film Club. And in addition, there will be an exhibition on the ink pictures of the kids. You saw it in the trailer. And the opportunity to use the workshop rooms to make things like flick books, etc., but also to have cake and enjoy the Saturday and to celebrate the Mini Film Club. It's just a loop of photos. It's not anymore connected to what I'm saying. So if you don't want to listen, just watch or do both if you like. The entire dramaturgy is designed to achieve the most sustainable learning possible by all those involved. It's children, educators, and parents. But also to create a bond with our house and the location of cinema in general. In our many years of work, we have discovered that the usual formats, one class comes into the house once for 1.5 hours or sometimes longer, 3 hours, were certainly valid and important, but do not achieve the goal that we have set ourselves with the Mini Film Club. We want to spread our cinephilia, because we are firmly convinced that cinema enriches our lives and the love for it automatically triggers the need for knowledge. We are not concerned with protecting young people from the media or acquiring competences. We believe that cultural education is a result of demanding aesthetic experiences. We also pursue a second goal radically with the Mini Film Club. We want to introduce the children to films that would otherwise be difficult for them to obtain. Nowadays, children grow up with a lot of moving images, less often in the cinema, but above all on a mobile phones, tablets, and television. And for us at the Deutsches Film Institut, it's like this. We think everyone should have the chance to get to know the whole spectrum, the whole variety that cinema has to offer, to really have the chance to develop one's own taste. Unlike Bergala, in this point our approach differs from our film education Bible. It is our Bible, but sometimes we also have a different position, cinema as art. We think that bad films also belong to cinema socialization and also have their justification. If I remember my own youth, Top Gun with Tom Cruise played a big role for me, and it's clearly not chic or intellectual, and I'm going to say it like this, yes, it was Top Gun, but there, here too, my heart, you know, cinema has caused my heart to beat and to feel intensity, and it didn't stop me from loving auteur cinema later on. And also, I'm a pacifist, so it's okay to have Top Gun in a special phase of my life. But commercial cinema and conventional aesthetics, even if we do not condemn them, find their audience on their own. No cinephile passeurs are needed for this. What we can do is to seize the opportunity to reach children in a phase of their lives in which they are still completely open to art and not yet fed up with prejudices about a reception that is supposedly too difficult. And here, the 4 to 6 years is very suitable. In music, we know the phenomenon of open-earedness. It goes up to the age of 6 or 7 years. After that, the accustoming to conventions becomes so strong that different things no longer simply get a positive judgment. This was really a big research about it. And it's not getting a positive judgment, but more quickly met with rejection. The good news, however, is that children have already had permanent contact with a diversity before 6 or 7, their openness can be maintained. That's why also we choose to have this age group. Now, in retrospect, when I present the project, I can explain it this way, but to be honest, we have approached the target group rather intuitively and experimented a lot. We were able to take time for reflection and learned a lot along the way. I can talk, as you see, about the Mini Film Club for a long, long time. My heart really beats for it, but Petra asked me in advance to address 2 aspects in particular, and I would like to fulfill this request, of course. On the one hand, the film selection, and on the other hand, the evaluation of our work. Let's start with the film selection. Here is much more to say. As I said, I brought the papers with the film titles, but you can see the pictures, but if you want to match it with the title, if you are interested, or just give it. These are the titles that are currently in the Mini Film Club edition, and we show them at the Mini Film Club. The educators pick 4 titles, as I already said, and we work intensively with the children on these films. And afterwards, after every session, that is also important, they bring home to their kindergarten the DVD like a treasure, so they really like to have the film in the end of the session and to bring it to the kindergarten. And how did we make the selection? First of all, in principle, we assume in our work that the selection of the film is an important central act. You also can find it on our website if it's not enough paper. I was not too many. First of all, in principle, we assume in our work that the selection of film is an important central act that goes hand in hand with a lot of responsibility. For the Mini Film Club, the first step was to establish a relationship of trust with two kindergartens and their pedagogical staff. We visited each other, we got to know our places and the concepts behind the work, and then we met regularly. We took our time. The program in which the Mini Film Club was funded, Kunst und Spiele, Art and Games, by the Robert Bosch Stiftung, miraculously made this possible. Normally, funding structures in Germany are different. You have to develop something purely purely hypothetically at your desk. You get money for it if you're lucky, and then in the end, it must inevitably be described as a success story, even if reality shows that things are different, and then you managed at your desk. Kunst und Spiele only required that we as a cultural institution formed a team with kindergartens and developed something together over a longer period of time. That was really a good situation to develop something. Trial and error was allowed and already planned, and I really think this is so important for developing cultural education formats in general. Simultaneously to the concept meetings, my colleague Daniela Dietrich and I started to work together on a film list and to pre-screen and filter the movies that we wanted to suggest to the educators. And we become more and more radical along the way. We didn't want colorful and cute animated films that were actually made for afternoon television. We didn't want identification figures with big eyes, no animals that conveyed simple moral messages. Not because we condemn these things, but because we thought this is a unique opportunity. We are in a network in this Kunst und Spiele, in this game and arts and game network. We are in a network with orchestras, theaters, and art museums. We want to choose really challenging cinema. Also because the pedagogical specialists permanently and empathetically encouraged us not to underestimate children at this age. They are very open and flexible in the head. Their eyes and brains are like sponges. They absorb all impulses. No quality had to be reduced because of them. On the contrary, if that happens, it's because of false preconceptions from adults. This gradually became clear to us, and the partnership with the kindergarten was fundamental for this. We then compiled an extensive list of short films, mainly abstract, avant-garde, and experimental films, but also short historical films, and a few narrative films that we really produced, for children were still there, but only ones that we felt we liked and that didn't demand too little of ourselves. This is perhaps always the only true selection criterion, also and especially for children and young people. Then we started to watch the films together with the educators. We discussed a lot. We were very lucky. We had met very open, art-loving pedagogical professionals who loved their children and really wanted to encourage them. Some films then have been eliminated from the list. Those that were too fast, Flickr films, for example, those that had threatening music, because preschool children are extremely sensitive for this, but also, for example, Lotte Reiniger's Papageno. It has an almost successful suicide in it, and to show this is not such a good idea if you're working with preschool children. Once we had agreed on the selection, we started testing with the children. We had a much longer list than the six films now we selected in the end. And that was also a very important learning step for us as a group. After all, we are very accustomed to relying on teaching by language, to on speaking about the films. But you cannot do this with 4 to 6 years old. And normally it gives us a security to share knowledge, to be able to explain, for example, what Norman MacLaren did there and that he was a very important film pioneer and so on. But this is not possible at many film club because the children are not really interested in this kind of information and in discovering it only on a language level. The works convince simply by themselves, some at least, and the others were then simply sorted out. For example, to my regret, A Man and His Dog Out for Air by Robert Preer, 1957, reoriented ourselves on the films which the children had a close relationship. And these were, above all, in which elementary things occurred that are important in this phase of the life, like stones, colors, shapes, shadows, for example, as you can see in the pictures. One important thing for us is also the connection between the moving images and the music, a wide range of music, which is unknown to the kids. It's a theme that runs through the whole mini film club, but we don't verbalize it. We just let them experience it. With success, we think, when we hear that the educators of a kindergarten are fed up with Oscar Peterson chess, while the kids can't get enough. Methodically, we always proceed like this in a mini film club session. And we also have developed this over a time. After a morning circle to get comfortable, we go to the cinema and watch the film. Everyone chooses their own seat in the cinema. At the beginning, everyone likes to sit in the front. In the long run, they move backwards. That alone I found really astonishing. During the film, the children talk all the time. It's 8 to 10 kids, so small groups are very important at that age, and it's also not easy to convince, for example, the head of the cinema department to open up the cinema for 8 children in the age from 4 to 6, but we were successful and we are resistant because it's necessary that they can have the space for them. It's their cinema in this, and this is also very important, I think. When they are watching the films, they describe what they see and they associate freely, and this alone is an amazing process that the accompanying adults enjoy a lot. It's really a social thing also. They comment to each other what they see and they discuss it while seeing it. And so it is also language, but in a completely different way. Then we go to the workshop rooms where we already prepared everything, and a lot of thought goes into this precise preparation. And we offer the children to open up on an aesthetic aspect of the film themselves and their own actions. This is not about their own filmmaking. Normally, everybody, very often teachers think the only thing is doing themselves films, but there are a lot of different things you can do without doing films. You have seen the photos, they explore ink and water, or they create stone pictures, they explore their colored shadows while dancing, and so on. The children work for themselves. We simply let them create and only support them if that is desired. The freedom in their own actions is very important for us. Once we had a Ukrainian Zend animator as our guest, who was supposed to make Zend pictures with the children after the visit of the cinema. And we were really shocked how badly she could withstand the abstraction and imperfection the children created. She repeatedly intervened in the resulting pictures of the children and tried to convince them to work figuratively and representatively. And we are not doing this. We are trying to achieve really openness, and I think it's also connected in the unit after the watching in the cinema to always have the same goal. After the active unit, we go back to the cinema, and as I said, we watch the film again, because you can do this with preschool children, and I think this is also a very important thing. It's not so easy to convince maybe a 12, 14, or 16-year-old to see it again and again, but in this age, they very much want to watch the films again and again and to learn to observe precisely and to develop a feeling for this medium of time, because they always have this feeling you can't catch it and you want to see it again. This is even perhaps more important in non-narrative films, I think. After the visit, they take the films to the kindergarten on DVD. And these DVDs we developed especially for the age group, so they do not have a menu and they have photos on the cover. So the goal is that the children in the kindergarten just pick them without having to read titles, and they just put it into the DVD player and it starts, so they don't, there is no barrier to see the film again. And we discovered really they also in the kindergarten they watch it again and again, and this is also a peer-to-peer thing. They show them to other children. Sometimes they dance to it in the kindergarten. They experience really the film with their bodies. Sometimes they make themselves comfortable and watched it in a relaxed way. It depends on the day and their moods. And somehow these films, they really, their films. They belong to their treasure of experience, and even if they know nothing about the filmmaker and usually do not even know the real title of the films, for them it's the stone film, for example, instead of Game with Stones. So what? By the way, Jan Schwankmeier, the head behind this film, gave us the rights for nothing because he liked our project so much. And now quickly, very quickly, to the second aspect, evaluation, a big and important topic. We often had lectures on this topic in Art and Games Network. The program itself is continuously evaluated by the Austrian company EduKult, but not on the effect of early childhood cultural education on children effect, because everyone involved agreed that this is almost impossible. Too many variables need to be considered. So at the moment, maybe this is going to change in future, but at the moment we do not make an official evaluation of the Mini Film Club ourselves. We only often take time to reflect on our observations and experiences, and one can say this is normal, but in our daily life we really discovered it's so important to see this is needed, and you really take your time, because normally so many organizational details and appointments and whatever in daily life, but really to fix dates, to sit down and have no other goal than to reflect on what you do, it's something precious for me. And an important observation is that children really learn best in relationships. So it is important for us, the Mini Film Club is always accompanied by the same person from start to finish, and that the accompanying educators do not remain in the role of passive consumers who have booked a course. At the beginning of each Mini Film Club, as I said, is a training course, but also shortly before the start, there is a so-called role discussion. And we, together with our kindergarten, go to in a double pack, so to say, and visit the kindergarten, and we talk on these topics. How can the visit on the Mini Film Club become sustainable through preparation and follow-up? How can the film find its place in the daily life of the kindergarten, even after the end of the Mini Film Club? And again, you can say it's completely not normal or whatever, to go with two persons, like cultural institution and kindergarten, to a kindergarten who booked a format with 8 children. But we discovered these things, to invest in these things, makes it sustainable in the end. It's so important. You can say, okay, but they only pay this and that if they book it, and you cannot have two persons go visit a kindergarten for this, but this makes the difference, in my opinion. We have a partner kindergarten in which a lot has changed over the last 4 years. They are on the way to write film into their concept of becoming a cinema kindergarten, comparable to a music kindergarten. And of course, we as a cultural institution, we have also developed very much in this partnership. Yeah, so far in this regard, and I'm happy to answer any questions. Thank you.